Did you know that between many different English-speaking territories across the world, nearly every single piece of animated material from the Dragon Ball franchise has had at least two different dubs? In our previous videos, we've extensively covered the history of the series' presence in America, but here's a quick refresher. In the 1980s, Harmony Gold had the first ever crack at dubbing Dragon Ball with the first and third movies using a Los Angeles-based cast recorded at Intersound Studios. A few years later, in the early 90s, Funimation acquired the rights to the series and recorded 13 episodes and one movie for Dragon Ball at Dick and Rogers Sound Studio, as well as eventually 53 episodes of Dragon Ball Z cut down from what was originally 67 at Ocean Studios, both in Vancouver, Canada. After splitting ties with Saban and briefly co-producing some uncut dubs with Pioneer for the first three DBZ movies on home video, Funimation ceased outsourcing their voiceover production to Canada for the show, tested the waters on the second Dragon Ball movie, and then picked up where they left off in Dragon Ball Z moving forward at a newly formed recording studio at Funimation's HQ in Dallas, Texas. The dub finished up until the end of Z, and this cast would go on to be the longest running and most recognizable cast for the franchise in English worldwide. Around the same time, however, in the early 2000s, a European broadcaster called the AB Group produced another separate dub of DBZ using Ocean Studios and much of its original cast, which starts around episode 123 and finishes up until the end of the series. This dub was created specifically for certain territories in Europe, and although it eventually made its way to Canada, fans up north can tell you that depending on the day, either the Canadian or American dub would play in alternation, so you could practically flip a coin and the cast might be different. In the mid-2000s, Funimation would eventually go back and re-record the first 67 episodes of DBZ with their Texas-based cast for American broadcast and a home release, as well as working on the movies and TV specials and simultaneously recording dubs for the original Dragon Ball, including the earlier 13 episodes already dubbed in Canada, and even Dragon Ball GT. Back in Canada, though, while Ocean Studios was only used for specifically DBZ, their sister company Blue Water Studios in Calgary recorded English dubs for the Canadian broadcast of Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball GT, using their own casts and were produced completely independently of Funimation's take on DBZ. Going back to a quick mention of the movies, however, is another English DBZ production by the AB Group of the two TV specials and first nine movies. These were recorded with English-speaking actors living in France, recognizable from such games as the Rayman series, Fahrenheit Indigo Prophecy, and Yesterday. These dubs, sadly, were made infamous on the internet and unceremoniously dubbed, or nicknamed, the Big Green Dub by the online fandom for their strange choice of renaming Piccolo.
Let that child alone.
The internet also has an unceremonious nickname for the Speedy Dub produced in Malaysia, for what is most likely meant to be an English as a second language audience.
I am the Saya people.
I'm the Saya people.
Yes.
A few particular anomalies mixed in here involve the third DBZ movie, Tree of Might, which also had a separate TV edited version recorded in Canada, split into three episodes during Z's syndicated broadcast, bringing the Tree of Might movie's total to five different English dubs.
Now then, Kakarot, if you want me to quit, you must kneel and beg for forgiveness.
My name is Goku!
What was that? Ah! Beg for forgiveness. And if you're lucky, I might spare your worthless life.
No! I made a promise to Gohan! I will beat you!
You fool, Kakarot.
Ask for pity now. I want to see you on your knees begging to have your life saved.
No. No way. I told Gohan one thing. That I would never surrender.
You'd rather I crush your head?
Now, Kakarot. If you want to live, you must kneel and beg forgiveness.
I don't know any Kakarot. That's not my name.
Don't you lie to me.
Say you give up. I will forgive you if you ask me to spare your life.
I made a promise with Gohan. I said that I must defeat you.
So you too, you can't Kakarot.
And even crazier, between the scene being repeated from the anime's first episode and in the first Dragon Ball movie, Curse of the Blood Rubies, the classic scene of Goku and Bulma meeting each other for the first time has at least a whopping seven different English dubs.
Wait a minute, are you
telling me you've never seen a girl before?
The only other person I've ever seen is my grandpa, and you don't look like him at all. In fact, you don't even have a tail.
Are you for real? A female, as in not a boy? My grandpa told me about girls, but I've never actually seen one. But grandpa told me if I ever met one of you girls, I should be as pleasant as possible.
Are you telling me that you've never seen a girl before?
The only person I've ever seen is grandpa, and you don't look like him. In fact, you don't even have a tail.
Oh my gosh, are you saying you've never seen a girl before?
Nope. Besides my grandpa, you're the only human being that I've ever seen.
Are you kidding me? Are you saying you've never seen a girl before?
Well, I know all about girls. My grandpa told me about them.
Are you joking? You mean you've never seen a girl in your entire life? No, nobody ever comes around here. The only human I ever saw was my grandpa. What is a girl exactly?
Or in your case, maybe not. You've seriously never seen a girl before?
The only other person I've ever seen is my grandpa, and you don't look like him. His chest bumps are bigger.
But believe it or not, it still doesn't end there, as even DBZ's revival in the form of Dragon Ball Z Kai has its complications. Around spring of 2010, Funimation recorded a complete dub of this remastered series with its Texas cast, including a few replacements for certain key characters. However, later in that same year, it began to let slip by many Canadian actors who had worked on DBZ at various times on various dubs that, in fact, another separate dub was being recorded for DBZ Kai at Ocean Studios. According to various sources confirmed by the actors themselves, Brian Drummond, Michael Dobson, and Scott McNeil were confirmed to be returning to the series as Vegeta, Nappa, and Piccolo, respectively. Interestingly, Brendan Hunter, who voiced Tien Shin Han in Blue Water Studios' Canadian dub of the original Dragon Ball, confirmed he would be returning to his role, as opposed to Vancouver actor Matt Smith, implying that the cast might have even been a mix of both locations in Canada that worked on the franchise. In addition, two major characters confirmed to be replaced by other Vancouver actors were Lee Tokar on the part of Frieza and Richard Cox as Goku. As of this video's creation in 2017, this supposed Canadian dub of DBZ Kai has yet to air in any English-speaking territory, and though it may even be fully recorded for the original run of 98 episodes, it still has yet to see the light of day. That said, in February of 2017, a fellow Shonen Jump series, Gintama, was dubbed in Vancouver, where Scott McNeil amazingly returned to voice a parody version of Piccolo, murdering an old man, which he also voiced.
I'm sorry to keep you. Now say your prayers. Special Beam Hunter!
As of this year, however, Funimation's had much greater luck in the form of DBZ Kai: The Final Chapters, adding another set of 69 episodes to complete the Kai series. In fact, it went on to air right alongside Funimation's English dub of the all-new series Dragon Ball Super on U.S. television on the likewise-revived Toonami block, where the franchise got much of its success in America. But, as commissioned by the show's creators at Toei Animation, the premiere of the North American English dub was beaten out by just a few weeks on Toonami Asia in English-speaking territories in Southeast Asia. This English dub was recorded at Bang Zoom Studios, coincidentally back in Los Angeles where Dragon Ball's very first English dub material came from. In fact, among its cast were the likes of Lex Lang as Goku, who previously once voiced Gohan in the PS1 game Dragon Ball GT Final Bout, also recorded in California, as well as Wendy Lee, who was the voice of Bulma in the Harmony Gold dub of Dragon Ball during the 80s, reprised her role well over 20 years later in the Southeast Asian dub of Dragon Ball Super.
Look at that ball carefully, kid. I'm sure your grandpa's has a different number of stars on it.
I swear I've never met a Saiyan so lacking in common sense as your father.
Funimation's North American dub premiered on January 7, 2017, while Bang Zoom's Southeast Asian dub officially began airing only a couple weeks later on January 22, 2017, separating the two dubs' broadcasting in their respective territories neck and neck by only two episodes. But perhaps the greatest coincidence, or perhaps irony in all this, is that while the Funimation English dub is mostly recorded in Texas, certain cast members who also happen to be living in Los Angeles were recorded instead at North Hollywood Sound, meaning that technically two different dubs of the same show were being recorded at the same time in the same city, walking distance away from each other. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't make this up. Thanks so much for watching. This video was inspired by Did You Know Gaming, so major shoutouts to them and go check out their channel and watch all their videos on gaming trivia. Special thanks to Omahdon for the audio mastering, my new soundtrack for the music, and the folks at Konzenshu for the helpful research. If you like this video, check out some of our other ones linked here, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want more.
Stay tuned.